If, and this is no secret, that we have seen an increase in violence. They claim an increase in radicalization. They obviously have access to information that I don't have. But if this is their reason for pulling out, then they are as much responsible as the PDP is. The PDP did not govern on its own. If the situation has reached the point where it has today, where we are all suffering, where all of you today are working under this shadow of great fear, then obviously they are both responsible for this. Both these parties together have pushed the state to this precipice. And we can only hope that with an able administrator like Governor Vohra, who has handled the state in very trying circumstances in the past, that we can begin the process of retrieving the state from the dark abyss that we are staring down. I have told you this many times over the last 3 years. That was a one-time offer. That offer expired the day the PDP and the BJP joined hands together. And anyway, I'm not in the habit of going to parties that I'm not invited to. They don't want my support. Why should I be offering it all the time? I'm not that desperate.
Is this the first ever breakup that National Conference will enjoy, perhaps political breakup that will enjoy?
We don't enjoy this breakup.
Sir, what would have been the reason for...
Please don't be under this mistaken illusion that we are in any way celebrating this breakup. We are not.
Sir, what
we are mourning the demise of democracy in this state. We are not celebrating it.
We want that at the earliest
available opportunity, that the people of Jammu and Kashmir are given a chance to decide their future again. This is not a time for no political party that believes in the process of elections will ever celebrate the imposition of governor's rule. And we are not celebrating this either. Look, again, I'm telling you, I can't speculate for what happened. I can't speculate if Shujaat's killing was the final straw that broke the camel's back. I can't speculate if the breakdown of the ceasefire was the final straw that broke the camel's back. Something happened. Now, it's not for me to speculate as to what that was. Now, what you're saying, that the situation has been deteriorating over time, I have been saying the same thing to you. For the last more than a year, I've been telling Mehbooba Mufti, look, for God's sake, please go. At this point in time, as a former chief minister myself, I can only say, personally speaking, I wish she had gone with some dignity intact. I wish she had chosen to go rather than be shunted out like this. But she chose not to. She chose to be dismissed rather than leave with some dignity intact. But that is something that she has to live with, not for me to live with.
Last one.
मैं नहीं कह सकता हूँ कि बीजेपी ने आखिरकार ये फैसला अभी क्यों लिया. लिया उनकी क्या मजबूरी थी ये तो सिर्फ बीजेपी वाले कह सकते हैं. लेकिन हालात खराब होते गए ये कोई छुपी हुई बात नहीं है. ये फैसला शायद उनकी मजबूरी बनी थी. अब आपने पूछा कि उन्होंने 3 साल कैसे निकाले, इक्तदार की लालच में और क्या. इक्तदार, अगर उनको इक्तदार इतना प्यारा नहीं होता, शायद महबूबा मुफ्ती जी इससे पहले ही इस्तीफा दे देती. मैं तो कहता हूँ जब उन मिनिस्टरों को अचानक दिल्ली बुलाया था कल, शायद उस वक्त वो दे देती. लेकिन बदकिस्मती से वो शायद अपने दफ्तर में बैठी हुई थी जब यहाँ से इन्होंने कुर्सी के नीचे से उनकी कालीन जो है वो अचानक खींच दी.
उमर साहब, एक सवाल.